It's all about transparency. It's all about community. It's all about, you know, making sure that we're holding folks accountable. And these are a package of bills that really was four bills that turned into two bills. And essentially what they do, we're creating a database that essentially allows different municipalities that may have transfer of police officers to know exactly what they're getting. I think this is very critical for the protection and the safety of all communities to know where individuals may have come from, what kind of misconduct they may have had in their previous positions. So we believe this is a great measure of transparency for our community and is essentially moving us forward. So it's like, don't pass the trash type bill. The second one kind of deals with like identifying different triggers or different signs of like either child abuse or being able to recognize some of this, the telltales that we know we want to protect the most vulnerable in our community. So we also have in that as a another like training piece of that bill to identify like, you know, racial training and just to make sure that folks have some type of diverse training, especially those who are going to be patrolling in urban settings. We think that is a critical piece of like training that all officers should have. And lastly, we deal with post-traumatic stress. One of the big key issues we know with a lot of our folks coming back from combat, they normally go into the police department. We want to make sure that we're protecting our officers, making sure that their mental health is something that we're evaluating and not like overlooking, because too often we overlook the signs of trauma. And now we're going to have an actual supervisor who's going to be specially trained to identify those signs. So we largely agree with the measures that's been put forward. We are thankful for all the folks who have been a part of this mission from the beginning. We want to thank our chairman on both sides, from the Republican and from the Democratic side, but also all the members who actually participated in those long debates and then really having a dialogue of figuring out where do we have common ground. So we're really excited about what the future looks like. And I think for the first time that our colleagues have really seen us as African-American legislatures and also heard some of the stories that we live on a daily basis, but they really get an opportunity to kind of learn from them and they can move forward. So we're thankful for it.